Hi, Andrea. Sherry here. So I'm going to be doing a divine partnership reading for you. So you've asked me some specific questions, so I'm going to look for those in the cards. I'm also going to be looking for the King of Swords, which would represent his energy. And I'm going to be looking for the Queen of Cups, which would represent your energy. Sorry, what did I say? His energy and then your energy. My God. Okay. So I'm going to be pulling 9 cards for the masculine and then 9 for the feminine using the John Holland Psychic Tarot. And then I'm going to be pulling 2 cards from Call It Baron Reed's Enchanted Map for a message from the universe and also using my cards for clarification. Okay, so for his love and relationship, this is how he views the relationship with you. Destiny. He feels like his heart chakra is opening. He feels like some major change is taking place within him. And he's looking to the future with optimism. He sees you as his destiny. So I'm going to be pulling cards for that, okay? All right, so what is he resisting? Temptation, the Devil card. There's a sense of scattered energy, not knowing which way to turn, believing you have everything worked out, but questioning yourself. So there's a sense that there's these fears that are holding him back from really pursuing what he wants. So the Temptation card also talks about addictions or codependent relationships. So perhaps there is a connection, a chain that he is bound to, that is preventing him from moving forward towards his destiny. Okay, so the message from his higher self. Material and spiritual prosperity, the Six of Pentacles. So this talks about having a return on the harvest, having a reward coming towards you from all the hard work that you've put in the past. This talks about what you reap, you sow. It also talks about being open to giving and receiving. So his higher self is telling him that he should be open and share in the material world, and that will help him in the spiritual realm. Okay, so for his recent past position, nice, memories of love, Six of Cups. So recently someone came into his life, possibly from the past, that made him feel childlike, innocent. There's pure love that is emanating from him. So when he thinks about a relationship from the past, it makes him, his heart chakra open. He sees this one star, this one light that he is attracted to, and he holds it gently in his hands, nurturing it, loving it. Okay, so for his present position, Two of Cups, awesome. Spiritual union, your mirror, your reflection. Future position, disruption, the Tower. So something is going to come in very suddenly in the future, and it is going to rock his foundation. it's going to destroy everything that he thought he was. It's a total change in lifestyle, which may have something to do with this devil card here. So there's a sense that, you know, he was holding on to some type of material possession because of the devil card that talks about placing too much emphasis on the material world. So the tower card also kind of has that same thing. You know, you've built up this identity in the material world. You've connected with that identity. And the tower comes in and destroys that, forcing you to let go of some things, whether you want to do it or not. And it's done so that you can move into the higher version of yourself, your true calling, your true purpose. It opens up a road for the future. So I'm going to be pulling a card for that as well. All right, so the message from the universe, recognition and reward, the Three of Wands, or Pentacles, sorry. So this talks about putting work into something in the past, and being recognized for that work. He's starting to see the fruits of his labor. He's standing on this podium and being enlightened. The light is shining on him. He's being recognized given a pat on the back for the work that he's done. So this could talk about building a 3D foundation, starting something in the material world, and then working towards that goal. So there's still work that needs to be done, but he's working towards it and reaping the rewards for it. Okay, so for the energy that's surrounding him, emotional withdrawal. I like this card. This talks about finally being ready to move on from something, to go within and really connect with your soul on a deep level and try and figure out why am I here? What is my purpose? What is the direction that I want to take? But more importantly, it talks about leaving a negative situation, finally ready to move on. So this is an energy that is surrounding him. So it seems to me like there's something in his environment that is causing him to feel like he needs to detach, to withdraw, to see things in a different light, to detoxify. But it's more of a soul quest for knowledge, inner wisdom. Okay, so for what he fears, Eight of Pentacles, positive movement forward. This talks again about building up some type of financial security in the 3D world. So he's definitely working towards finding some sort of balance between the physical and the spiritual. He has a goal in mind and he's working towards that. See how the sun, he's moving and looking towards the sun. He feels very optimistic about his future. But this is in his fear position. So I'm getting a sense that he's afraid to move forward with something that he is connected to in the 3D world. And it has to do with work. Maybe he feels he might not reach that ultimate goal. I'll pull a card for that. Okay, so for your love and relationship, how you view this relationship. Power, the strength card. So this relationship is drawing out this strength and courage from within you. You are taming the beast within. You're controlling any urge to empower someone. You're using your kindness, your compassion, and your heart center to deal with situations and people around you. So because this is in love and relationship, I'm getting the sense that he makes you feel loving, compassionate, and at peace. In the Rider-Waite deck, it depicts a woman. She's leaning over and she's petting a lion who is submitting to her. So, I see this very loving, kind energy coming from you. Okay, what are you resisting? Choosing wisely, the Seven of Cups. So you don't see your way clearly. You have a lot of options available to you, but you don't have a direct link to that ultimate goal. See, here we have him in the boat, and he's actually moving towards that directed goal, but it is something that he fears. And here, you're sitting on the dock. You're still in a stationary position. You're, this is going to be your resisting position. So you're resisting making a decision. Spirit is asking you to calm your mind, be that figure on the dock, retreat, go within, and the answers will come. Okay, so the message from your higher self, new beginnings, zero, the Fool card. So you want a brand new beginning. You want to start fresh. And again, that has to do with this Seven of Cups card. I'm so sorry. I just got a tickle in my throat here. So that has to do with making a decision to move forward. You really want to go forward with something, but you're hesitating here. You're hesitating making a decision. Whereas this card is making that decision and then actually taking that step towards your destiny. So this talks about facing your fears, looking at this as if it were a new adventure. Looking at it through a child's eyes, innocent, free, having no expectations, but just moving forward, taking that step into a brand new beginning. Okay, so for your recent past position, crown chakra, you are activated and connected to the max. So recently you had a grand awakening. Something occurred, possibly a synchronicity or the meeting of someone. And it catapulted you to a higher level of awakening, higher level of consciousness. So this is your connection to the collective, the ethereal light. You are definitely awake. Okay, so present position, Three of Wands. So partnerships and alliances. So this talks about, in the Rider-Waite deck, it talks about making plans, like having this spark of an idea, being excited about it, having this vision, this goal, and then making plans and putting those plans into motion. And now you're waiting for that payoff to come back. So this also talks about forming alliances and partnerships, being connected and working as one. There's also a sense of there needs to be an even energy exchange. So you want things to be balanced. You want to come together to work as one and move towards this directed goal, together. So the card above that is this scattered energy. I don't know where, which way to reach out. And then here we have that solid connection, of reaching out and coming together. So this is your present position. His present position is the Two of Cups, spiritual union. So there's like this connection between the two of you. Okay, so future position, nice. Awareness, the Magician, the Master Manifester. This guy is connected through the crown chakra to higher consciousness. He's awake, aware, and he is able to manifest whatever his heart desires into the 3D. So he can materialize his thoughts into reality. So this card says that you already have all the tools you possess to achieve your highest goal. So something is going to manifest in the future. Okay, so a message from the universe, wisdom, the Hierophant, the High Priest. I'm getting the sense here that you are more conscious than he is. He got this Three of Pentacles. So, you know, it's a very dim light of illumination. It's a crack, a small opening in his soul. He's starting to let that light in. Whereas you are burst wide open. You are coming in as this leader, this, you know, this person who has all this spiritual wisdom and knowledge, and you want to share it with the world. It's almost like you're helping guide him into the light by providing this safety, this space where you can share ideas and help each other grow, becoming your highest version of yourself. Okay, so for the energy that's surrounding you, oh my God, that's awesome. Third eye chakra. Somebody is connected to you through the ethereal, through the third eye. You can see how, you know, this couple here is connected at the through the third eye chakra. So there's a sense that somebody is near you in your surrounding and you're connected to them. You're able to communicate using your third eye. You're able to see visions and use your inner seeing to guide you. But there's definitely that connection there. Your chakras are lit up. Okay, what do you fear? The Nine of Pentacles, material harvest. That's interesting. He fears the Eight of Pentacles. So the Nine of Pentacles, that talks about ripeness, harvest, everything that you've worked to finally displayed in front of you. It's recognition, reward, it's abundance. But it talks about ripeness, you know, the fruit being ready to fall from the tree. So maybe you fear not having this manifestation of abundance. Okay, so now I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck. Obstacles and challenges. So the Five of Wands, it talks about there being small obstacles, small challenges that need to be overcome before you can move forward on your path. So there's a sense that there's some kind of competition surrounding you, rivals, and you're trying to figure out a way to make your light shine. So it's a shared energy, right? So it's the energy that is surrounding the entire reading. So I'm going to pull the clarifiers now, starting with the overall energy. What is this Five of Wands spirit, please? What is this competition? Can you give us more clarity? Starting with the feminine aspect first, please. Ten of Wands. So there's a sense of you feeling overburdened here. You feel like you've taken on too much responsibility. And you're unable to delegate that responsibility to relieve the stress. You feel like you're ready to give up. So that coupled with the Five of Wands up there, there seems to be, you know, a lot of stress involved with this obstacle, this challenge. But in reality, I mean, that's just a small step, a small crack in the road that you just need to walk over. I just noticed that the throat chakra is below. I don't know if you can see that, yeah. So it's underneath. So there's a sense that there needs to be some type of communication regarding that obstacle. Okay, so what is the masculine, please? Judgment. I knew it. So this is that grand awakening. It's a rebirth. It is stepping into enlightenment. It is a brand new beginning, new start. But it also talks about reviewing your life and seeing it from a different perspective. Seeing how most of your, almost all of your life has to do with conditioning. You know, being forced to act a certain way. You know, follow rules, constructs. But then also taking on all these past stories from your ancestors, from your parents, that you wear like a heavy blanket. So this is stripping away all of that, all those stories, the identity, and stepping into a spiritual state of mind. So it's a grand awakening. So that's no small obstacle. That is a major leap forward in consciousness. And it's causing you stress. So it seems to me like he's going through an awakening period right now. He is coming into consciousness. He's letting go of those material attachments. He's stepping onto the podium. Stepping into the light. Okay, so I wonder if I can move these down just a bit. So I think I'm going to pull one clarifier for each card, okay? All right, so for this Destiny card, Spirit, does he see her as his final destination? Does he feel like this is destiny, meant to be? Do you have any additional messages for us? Nice! Oh my God, yeah! Awesome! Awesome, this is the Four of Wands. This is the 1111 Twin Flame calling card. I don't know if he's aware of it or not, but there is that twin flame connection and he sees you as his destiny. This is confirmation that he wants to move towards this ultimate love. This, you know, there was that spark that was lit in the past and now it's like this roaring fire of warmth and love and excitement. And but the Four of Wands also talks about, you know, that final place where doesn't necessarily have to be a final place, but it's a time of accomplishment, completion. It's the same sensation that you get when you buy your first home. There's that sense of beginning but ending at the same time. There's optimism for the future. It's feeling excited and surrounded by peace and harmony. So that coupled with the Wheel of Fortune card is telling me that the tide has turned, that abundance is coming, and to be ready for it. Open your heart chakra and be ready to receive. So this is how he views the relationship with you, as this twin flame connection, and you are his destiny, whether he's aware of it or not. Okay, so what is this temptation card, please, Spirit? The Seven of Pentacles. So this is putting a lot of work into something and waiting. It's a pause. It's waiting for that payoff. So there's a sense that he feels successful in the 3D world. And he's planning for the future, but he can't move forward with it just yet because of this attachment that he has. This negative energy or chain that he is linked to. So this also talks about having patience as well. It's that pregnant pause. Everything has a time. So it's almost like he's been waiting for something to occur for a long time. But he can't. He feels linked to something. All right, so what is the Six of Pentacles in message from his higher self, please, Spirit? Six of Pentacles, again, it's the same card, being open. Being open and generous. I'm going to pull one more card for that. King of Cups. So this could be your energy, Cancer. But I'm kind of seeing it as his energy, in that he wants to feel like this king. The King of Cups is emotionally abundant. He has his emotions under control. He's very loving, kind, and it's a pure love. It's a very deep love. So that coupled with the two sixes, Six of Pentacles, is telling me that he's working on being open and loving in the 3D world. He wants to be open and show his love. And he's doing that. He's working towards it. Okay, so what is this Six of Cups in his recent past position, Spirit, please? Nice. Three of Wands again. So that is in your present position. So, yeah, there's that sense of reaching out. But it also talks about having that your ship's coming in, seeing a payoff. And partnerships, alliances, reaching out. So this is coming in his past position. It has to do with memories of love. So I'm getting a sense that something occurred in the past where it opened him up. It made him think of, you know, a different destination or goal. And, you know, coming together as one. What is this disruption card, please, Spirit? Ten of Pentacles. So it's that happy ending. It is working your entire life to build up a wealth, and then it's like a sense of retirement in the future. But it also talks about having family and friends around you is the most important, not what you've built up. But there's that sense of, you know, strong family values. It's a time of peace, rest, and relaxation. So that with the Tower card. It's almost like something's going to happen suddenly in the future that will just disrupt his idea of his final destination. Or it will bring that abundance in towards him. Okay, so what is this Three of Pentacles in message from his, from the universe? Eight of Swords. So Eight of Swords is a mental trap. It is a self-imposed prison. It is feeling like you can't move forward with something. So, and it has something to do with the 3D world. I'm going to pull one more card for that. Nine of Wands. So the Nine of Wands talks about being exhausted. You are the wounded warrior. You are out for the count. You can't go on anymore. But there's still that strength within you to get up and fight that one last fight. So that, coupled with the Eight of Swords, is telling me that there's an energy that is keeping him locked behind this prison. It makes him feel like this wounded warrior. But he's stepping into the light. It's a small step towards light, but it's happening. He's trying to release himself from that chain in the past. Okay, what is this emotional withdrawal, please, in his external environment? The Wheel of Fortune again. So he got that in his how he views the relationship with you. So he's withdrawing from something emotionally. He is connecting with his heart chakra and healing himself. And he's doing it because he feels that he knows what his destiny is. There's wind of change blowing through this entire reading. And it's a major change. Major shift in consciousness. So, yeah, it's almost like you're helping him heal his heart. I'm almost seeing you as this energy, the Ten of, you know, the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so what is this Eight of Pentacles? Why does he fear the Eight of Pentacles, please, Spirit? Seven of Cups again. That's this energy up here. So, this talks about not knowing if things are real, if it's an illusion, if this destiny or destination that he wants to work towards is real. Is it an illusion? Is it just a fantasy? So that's where the fear is coming from. Okay, so one more card for the spiritual union, please, Spirit. What is this? Whoa, jumped out. So that's a Tower card, just jumped out. Yeah, oh wow, eh? So something big is happening. It's a transformation. It's a total lifestyle change. It has rocked his foundation. It is tearing down all of his beliefs, his constructs, and it's happening in order to bring this love in, the spiritual union. All right, what is this strength card in your love and relationship position? Spirit, can you give us more information about this strength card? The Sun. So this is the best card in the major arcana. On fire. Wow. The strength card is also a fire card as well. So things are really lit up between the two of you. So the strength card, that's abundance. That's everything good coming back or coming towards you. You feel like the sun when you think of him. You feel empowered. You feel abundance, innocence, playfulness, harmony, peace, all the good things. It's the most positive card that you can get. Okay, so what is this decision that needs to be made that you are resisting? What is this decision that she is resisting? Ten of Swords. So, there's a decision that has to be made to cut away something, to end something. And this usually talks about going through a dark night of the soul. So it is completely cutting away negative people, negative energy, negative situations. And once that takes place, then you will be able to see your path clearly. So there's a sense that you're resisting letting go of something. You're resisting cutting away something that is creating that obstacle and is causing you to feel exhausted, overburdened. Okay, so what is this Fool card, please, Spirit? Ace of Pentacles. It's a brand new beginning in the 3D world. It is a key to the door. You want to start in the 3D world. You want to step forward with this new beginning, this new journey. So it's almost like Spirit is coming in with this key and offering it to you. So what I'm getting here is that you want this new beginning and Spirit is saying go for it. Okay, what is this crown chakra in the recent past position, please, Spirit? Got a lot of eights in your reading. A lot of eights, a lot of sixes. Eights is infinity. Karma coming back to you. You reap you sow. A lot of nines as well. Nine is completion. Seven of Swords. That doesn't make too much sense to me. Why would you be connected through the crown chakra and feel like somebody is deceiving you? These are both sevens. Maybe it's something in your environment that is causing you to feel like, you know, somebody's deceiving you or backstabbing you or, you know, sneaking away in the middle of the night, not confronting you with communication. It wouldn't make sense because that kind of reflects this energy up here as well. There's that obstacle because of communication. I'm going to pull one more card for that, please, Spirit. The King of Wands. So this would represent a fire energy, a fire sign. This person represents a leader, somebody who is an entrepreneur, might own their own business. They make the decisions. They usually get people motivated to move forward with a project, but it is a project that he's not interested in the details. He gets other people to do the work for him. So is there, maybe there's somebody in your environment that is a leader, I'm just looking at the other cards here. Okay, I'm going to pull a card next for the partnerships and alliances, because it seems to me like it's connected to that, and then it might give me a little bit more clarity. What is this Three of Wands, please, Spirit? Because it shows up twice. It shows up in his past position as well. Eight of Pentacles. Again, that's this card here. So Eight of Pentacles with the Three of Wands. So it has to do with a work environment. Eight of Pentacles is working towards something. It is an ordinary life. You wake up in the morning, you go to work, and you come home. It's a routine over and over and over again. And it seems to me like there's that connection in that you're both working towards a goal, and you're doing it as, you know, you're doing it together. So this could represent somebody who's very charismatic, who's outgoing, who shines in the light. But there's that deception that is associated with it. I guess only you will know what that means. But it somehow has to do with the crown chakra and being connected to source. So let's pull a card for that magician. It seems to me like that energy is connected to that as well. Death card. Awareness. Magician and the Death card. So something's going to come to an end in the future. And as a result, there's going to be a new manifestation of something into the material world. But a major metamorphosis is going to take place in the future. It's regarding a tower. But it'll open up that road for, you know, a new beginning. What is this this Hierophant in Message from the Universe, please, Spirit? Eight of Cups again. That's this card. So this is in his surrounding environment, and it's coming in as a message from the universe for you. So, yeah, it kind of has that same ring or tone to it, that you are that leader, and he's walking towards you. He's moving away from something negative in his environment, allowing destiny to take control and accept that change. And here we have him moving towards that spiritual wisdom. So maybe you had a deep conversation with him that opened that crown chakra in the past, but instead of you feeling like, you know, it was successful, it resulted from him walking away and hiding. But here we have him walking towards you now. The Eight of Cups is a pilgrimage on a quest for spiritual wisdom. But it's an emotional one. It's a sense that he hit rock bottom, and now he's moving towards the light. Okay. So you're kind of helping him out of that mental prison. Yeah, he's definitely showing up as that wounded person. Okay, what is this third eye chakra, please? Five of Wands, that's this card up here. The surrounding energy. Five of Pentacles with the third eye chakra. Or sorry, Five of Wands. Pull another card. Two of Pentacles. Finding balance. Maybe you feel that, you know, you have this connection, this third eye connection. But it's not moving forward. It's causing an obstacle, which is creating stress for you, but Spirit is telling you to find that balance from within. Be flexible, bend with the wind, and put down some of those burdens, that stress. So it's almost like, you know, there's these obstacles, challenges that are causing you to feel imbalanced. But you need to meditate. Be in the now. Don't involve yourself in this conflict. But this card also talks about finding a way to let your light shine, right? You feel like you're competing with somebody that is causing you to feel imbalanced, but there's this higher connection here, this third eye chakra that stands out. There's that crown chakra that stands out amongst that negative energy. You know, there's this sun, this male who represents the sun, who is the light, which is the crown chakra. It's your, you know, your connection to light. But there's that negative energy, that's deception, that feeling of not having all the information, or somebody's deceiving you, which is causing that conflict and an imbalance, and it's closing that door. I hope this makes sense to you. Only you'll know if it, you know, if you resonate with it. I'm kind of curious if you want to email me back and let me know. Okay, so what is this Nine of Pentacles? Why do you fear it? Oh, two cards came up. Nice! The Knight of Cups, an invitation of love. It's a poetic, loving gesture. And then you got the Fool card. Again, new start, that new beginning key. It's what you fear. You feel that things aren't going to materialize, that this love of your life, this person that makes you feel, you know, abundant, in love and an expression of love, isn't going to materialize, isn't going to happen, and it's not, you're not going to get that new beginning. You fear it. But I think this is confirmation that Spirit is telling you, yeah, there is going to be this love, this offer of love coming towards you in the future, which is going to create that new beginning for you. Okay, so I am going to pull a message from the universe, two cards. And I will read those to you, and then I'll have a look at the spread and see if there is any additional messages that I might have overlooked. Okay, what is your message for Andrea, please, Spirit? Protecting treasures. There's a fear of you losing your treasure. Or not having the treasure. So this talks about not to worry, that everything is protected. everything that you've worked towards is protected. So you can go ahead with that idea that you had. So I'm going to read that to you. Oop. And for the masculine, please follow the leader. I knew it. I knew it. You are the leader. You are helping him step into his higher calling. Right now, he's showing up as this wounded person, emotional, and the constructs of his reality is coming down. He no longer, he's willing to detach from these constructs and have this beginning of love. So yeah, I'm going to read that to you as well. So that's being your true authentic self, looking at the people in your surroundings and emulating them. Okay, I'll see you in a moment. Okay, so I've had a chance to look at your spread. It's a pretty big spread. Okay, so what I'm getting here is, you know, everyone is at different stages of their journey. Some are more advanced than others. And it seems to me like you're both kind of, you know, stepping into your knowing. This crown chakra is I know. It's being enlightened. You, however, are coming in with this stronger knowing, but you're questioning it. But you are offering that guidance, that pull towards union or towards, you know, your higher purpose, which will be manifested in the future. So I wanted to start with this card here. The Five of Wands. So this is that shared energy. It represents the energy of the entire reading. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly read it to you. Okay, so obstacles and challenges. This card represents the obstacles, power struggles, and challenges that you must face in order to overcome them. This could be a difficult period to get through, but it's not impossible. If you open your mind and see the bigger picture of how things went wrong, don't get caught up in it. Just pause and stand back for clarity. Observe where adjustments are required or which decisions need to be made to be able to move you forward in a positive direction. Life really is about learning. Don't play the victim. Take the knowledge you've gained from this experience so that you can apply it to similar situations in the future. This card often comes forth when competition is around you, whether it's in your personal or business life. This is an excellent time to think creatively. Ask yourself, how can I make my life light shine above all the rest? So yeah, there's that sense that you're trying to figure out how to make your light shine, how to overcome this obstacle. But these obstacles, these light challenges, are just meant as like stepping stones. So once you get past that obstacle, there's always going to be a return, a reward as a result of it. Okay, so you got the Ten of Wands, and he got the Judgment call or card. So the Ten of Wands talks about feeling overburdened. You are too stressed up about this obstacle that you need to overcome. So Spirit is telling you to lay down those wands and rest, relax, let go of it. Because there really isn't anything that you can do to you know, move things along faster. The evolution or awakening process is a very long road. So it seems to me like he is stepping into that awakening. And it's a much larger challenge than what you need to overcome. You're trying to figure out how to make your light shine, which you are going to be doing. You got the Sun card, which I'm going to read to you. Okay, so that's the overall energy for the reading. So I'm just going to pause it for a moment. Okay, so back over to his side. So the way he views love and relationship is his destiny card. Okay, so there is a sense that there is change coming in, and it's imminent. And he is learning how to open his heart and accept love into his life. And since, you know, that 11-11 calling card came in, it's giving me a sense that he knows what his destiny is, but he's just trying to figure out a way to make that manifest. But there's something that's holding him back, a chain. So he's reevaluating his life, his goals. He's in a place of reflection. He's trying to figure out how he can manifest this outcome. But there's, like I said, there's these attachments, these chains that are preventing him from moving forward. So in his message from his higher self, he has an optimistic outlook. He wants, he is putting a lot of work into, you know, manifesting his dreams. He feels successful. But there's that sense of the King of Cups here. I'm getting the sense that he's learning how to be open in terms of his emotions. Okay, so on to his past position. You know, he felt this loving connection in the past, and it activated him. He got excited about it, and he wanted to manifest that into reality. So here we got his present position. It's that Two of Cups, that union, that spiritual bond, your reflection. And he feels unstable. We got the Tower card that's accompanying it. So he feels unstable, like the, you know, his foundation is crumbling. Like, you know, some major life choices and changes need to occur in order for this union to manifest. So in the future, it looks to me like that Tower will occur. The Tower will come down. And as a result, this Ten of Pentacles will manifest. So it's that happy ending. It's that, you know, prosperity, abundance. But it is, you're not connected to the material aspect of it. You are happy and at peace just being, you know, with family and friends and your loved ones. So for his message from the universe, we got this beginning of an illumination, an awakening. He's stepping onto the podium, and he's allowing that light to shine down on him. So he's removing those constraints. He's moving away from that mental prison, that devil card there. So he's allowing that tower to fall. And finding his strength, but also healing his heart at the same time. So the energy that's surrounding is that Eight of Cups. I wanted to read that to you, but it's all about, you know, that pilgrimage, finding yourself. And that's coupled with that Wheel of Fortune again. So major change, major cycle. There's a crashing down, you know, a whirlwind of activity, but there's that resistance of moving forward because of it. All right, so let me just read that Eight of Cups. Okay, emotional withdrawal. This card represents moving away or withdrawing from current situation in your life, whether it's love, relationship, or leaving behind what was once familiar in search of new horizons or new beginnings. On a physical level, it's easy to get caught up in the materialistic world, but it's just as important to retreat from the outside world to enable you to pause, reflect, and heal. Schedule some alone time so you can commune with your soul and give the power of spirit the opportunity to restore your energy level, giving you vitality to move forward in a positive direction. The number 8 represents infinity, passion, control, and power. This is your time. Use this opportunity to tap into your heart and soul in order to find courage and strength to continue your journey into that wonderful undiscovered territory. All right, so there's a sense that he's withdrawing from his external environment. and really connecting with his heart, opening his heart chakra, and accepting that change in order to move forward. Okay, so then we've got over here in his fear position, the Eight of Pentacles. So that's that movement forward. He's afraid to take that step forward because he feels that, you know, this is maybe an illusion. But yeah, there's the tower will come in whether he likes it or not. Things that were built on that faulty foundation was meant to come down. You can't continue holding on to these falsehoods. It will eventually collapse. So yeah, he's going through a transformation. He's withdrawing in order to heal his heart and allow love to come into his life, and the tower will come down, and you know, there'll be that drastic change. Okay, so for your love and relationship, you got the Strength card. That's using compassion, kindness, and love when dealing with your partner. And you got the Sun card on top of that, so I just wanted to read that to you. So, light. This card reassures you that it's your time to be in the light, no matter what's happening around you. Okay, so you are in the light. Your light is shining. No matter what's happening around you, prosperity and bliss are promised. These qualities, the qualities of this brilliant card are pleasure, happiness, contentment, growth, success, joy, illumination. The light always brings forth new birth, a constant renewal of life. This is one of the best, if not the best, most positive card in the deck, and it's yours. This is now your moment to shine. The radiance within will be there for all to see as people become attracted to your rays of spiritual light. And by being compassionate, generous, inspiring, and a leader, many will benefit as they feel the warmth emanating from you. Be discerning, but also be open to whatever or whomever you're attracting, for your rays reach far and wide. The light card reminds you that because of its power, nothing remains in the dark. Through its illumination, truths and certain paths before you begin to emerge and can be surely seen. Using this energy of positive thoughts and continually thinking about the happiest and most joyful of memories will light the path before you even more brightly and attract exactly what you're emanating. Keep on shining. So there's that sense that you are providing that light, that those happy memories from the past, and it's giving him direction. Okay, so for what you're resisting, there's that sense of not knowing which direction to take and considering cutting the link to something, or resisting cutting that link to something, letting go of some type of negativity that you're holding on to, and it seems to be coming in from this past position, this feeling of being deceived, not knowing if you can trust. But you are the illuminated one. You are the shining light in the sky that is attracting people into your environment. And that shows up with the crown chakra as well. This is, I know, it is thought, it is your link to the light source. So the King of Pentacles, he's somebody who draws people in using that light. So I just wanted to read that to you. So I'm reading this from the Tarot Illuminati. Okay, the center of the sun. The strongest desires burn with the most heat. The strongest of wills burn brightest. And heat always rises. I am the height of my very self, the pinnacle of everything that is possible, the achievement of all things. I am everything that ever wanted to be and more. And I am a master of all. The four worlds are at my fingertips, all skills in my knowledge. I have seen the world, and I have heard all its songs. met all the people, loved fiercely and deeply, adventured beyond the limits of my perception. There is nothing I cannot do, nothing I do not want to do. I live on it. I thrive on it. I am God incarnate, seated upon a sunlit throne, the center of the universe. I burn as brightly as a midday sun. Once you have beheld me, you will never forget me. So yeah, this is, I'm sensing that because you're coming in as the sun, you're also coming in as this strong energy, this King of Wands, this bright light. So although there's this feeling of doubt and betrayal, you're moving on from it. You're letting that go. So your present position, it seems to me like you are working hard to shape your surroundings. So you have this goal in mind, and your force of will is directed towards that goal. So you're starting to experience this payoff, this these rewards for your hard work. So as a, oops, I missed your message from the higher self. There's that journey, that beginning, that new start. And I just wanted to read that to you quickly. So this is new beginnings. The beginning of the Fool's journey. And no, actually, you didn't get the World card. Okay, so each and every journey begins with that all-important first step. When this card presents itself in a reading, it's confirming that it's time for you to take a brave leap of faith. But be prepared as you do so. This card represents that a great new adventure is awaiting you. It usually shows up when there's a significant inner change happening within you. By selecting the card, it's a sign that those important choices are needed or about to be made and should be carefully pondered as you proceed with wisdom, thought, and care. So that's what that Seven of Cups up there talks about as well. It's, you know, really sitting down and looking at your situation and using careful thought in order to move forward. So life is constantly trying to nudge and move you forward. At times it can be daunting when faced with a new adventure or direction. Therefore, it calls for an inner belief and courage as you take that leap of faith, inner courage. And step into the unknown. During this time, don't be alarmed if you feel lost or even confused. Most people are afraid of change and play it safe by staying where they are. Know that through inner guidance, wisdom, and belief in yourself, and by tapping into these tools, you'll be propelled forward on a positive, life-changing path. Don't conform to what society or other individuals expect of you at this time. It's your own adventure. During this time, be like an innocent child with fresh eyes and give yourself permission to live, play, love, and above all, laugh. Okay, so you've also got the Ace of Pentacles as well. So that's that seed being planted. Prosperity begins. It's that new start in the 3D world. So you are considering taking that step, that having that new beginning, okay? And in your future position, we got that new beginning coming in, manifesting. So this is number one. That was zero. That's that thought, that consideration, that planning. And then here we got in your future that step, that that movement into the material world, that manifestation, that beginning. And it came as a result of this death card, this major transformation that occurred. So in order for this new beginning to come into reality, to be manifested, there's a major death of something, a clearing out, a letting go of an old identity. So in your message from the universe, we got this Hierophant with the Eight of Cups. So that was the card that I read to you. It's that pilgrimage. It's withdrawing from negative energy around. But I'm feeling like this is his card. And he's walking towards this spiritual wisdom, this guidance, this the sun. Okay, so the energy that's surrounding you, this one kind of threw me for a loop. So we got that third eye chakra, that inner seeing, coupled with the Two of Pentacles and the Five of Wands. But I'm feeling that it's that repeated message up here of trying to figure out how to make your light shine. But you are the sun, okay? So you are using your inner knowing, your inner seeing to find balance while this chaos is, or this competition is kind of swirling around in your environment. But I think Spirit is saying that you are awake, aware. So if you feel unstable, just tap into that inner knowing, that inner seeing. And that will help you find clarity. So what you fear is not having that this ripeness, this manifestation, this harvest. But Spirit is telling you that there is love, a love connection on its way, and which will result in that brand new beginning. All right, so I'm going to read these two final cards to you, messages from the universe. It's kind of neat how you got 39 and he got 40. All right, so you got protecting treasures. You're always protected and divinely directed. Although this is a time of great risk, know that at a fundamental level, you are able to move forward safely and securely. The proverbial nest egg is safe and sound no matter the fluctuations in the outer world. Guardian angels and other guides are whispering to you, making you aware of their protective presence. Your loyalty is an important theme now. Nurture that which you hold dear. This is a good time to strengthen bonds of friendships, ensure their integrity. If you feel tested right now, know that a true and loyal heart will always achieve its aim. Take refuge under an angel's wing. You are not alone and have no need for fear. Embrace your courage. Okay, so number 40 is his card, follow the leader. Every life is a teaching tool for others. Your authenticity and honesty are an example to those around you. You are being called to lead others by example. Your wisdom has been earned as a result of your bravery in the adventure of your life. The experience of battles won and lost, places discovered, tears shed, and joy revealed have placed you in a unique position to be of service to others. Your suffering has been crystallized into the talisman of wisdom. Now you must share it by being your fully authentic self. You'll lead others into the light. You'll be required to divulge some things about your past so that you may help someone else. Lead with love. There is another message here as well. Look at those whose great character and accomplishments you admire. Emulate the leaders you respect. You will then, in turn, have more to offer. Okay, so it seems to me like he's being drawn towards that leadership, that light. And you have nothing to fear, that you are protected. All right, I hope this helped. Much love. Cheers.